Alright guys, today we are here for the upgrade of the 15-inch MacBook Pros late 2012. So this is the base model, the i7 quad-core processor, 2.3 GHz, with the NVIDIA GeForce GD650M with half gigs of RAM. So we are going to upgrade the RAM. Now it's 4 gigs. I'm gonna stick inside 2 modules by 8 gigs each of this RAM, the Corsair Vengeance 1600 MHz, and we're going up to 16 gigs of RAM. Then the base model here has 500 gigabytes mechanical hard drive. We are gonna stick in the Corsair Neutron GTX 240 gigs SSD, this one. Okay, and we are gonna stick in a second hard drive, an Hitachi 750 gigs, 7200 RPMs, using this great stuff I bought from the UK for almost 16 euros, and this is the super drive case for a second hard drive. So this is the main reason I bought a normal MacBook Pros instead of the Retina ones, because I don't need that amazing screen quality. I'm just fine with the 1440x900 that the standard MacBook Pros is delivering, but it's really important for me the storage, and I need an SSD and to upgrade to a mechanical hard drive. And in the MacBook Pro Retina you can't do that. There is no space, not enough space to upgrade to two hard drives, and you cannot upgrade the RAM, so you have to spend a lot of money for the standard one with 16 gigs of RAM, if it's possible. I'm not sure that you can go up to 16 instead of the standard 8 gigs. Well, actually, you're not gonna need 16 gigs of RAM very often, but when you need it, it's better that you have it. So we'll see. Now I'm just removing the 10 screws that holds back the back panel, so they are all the same, just these 3 ones are longer to hold the chassis in place. So it's possible that we are done. It's not that easy right now. In the 13-inch, I remember it was easier, because you just need to pull it up, so then it's done even here. So let's just take the last screws in here. So let's focus. Well, this is actually the 15-inch MacBook Pros on the inside. So the first thing you have to do is to unplug the battery, so you don't risk to make danger or trouble. Now I'm gonna touch something made of steel iron on my desk that touches the ground to ensure I have no there's no trouble that I can destroy my motherboard with static electricity. So remove the battery connector, then we can go for the hard drive. So after this installation of the SSD, I'm going to freshly install Mountain Lion 10.8, and so before doing this you need to create your USB USB system installer. So before, we have to remove this holder for the hard drive with this normal standard screws. Then you can pull up the hard drive gently and remove the connector, the SATA connector. So here we have the standard hard drive, is a Toshiba 500 gigs, 5400 RPM, so it's really not fast at all. We are gonna need this screw to hold all these four screws to hold in place the SSD, so we are gonna need a little Torx screw driver, and we just need to remove. So now we have the four holder in place, just connect the SSD to the SATA 3 connector, stick the two holder in place, and then stick everything in place, and finally the holder right here. I hope I don't need to remove this holder later when I need to install the second hard drive and to remove the super drive. So be careful when you screw in and unscrew all the screws. Be gentle, don't destroy anything. But let's move on. The SSD is in place. Now we have the RAM. So just pull aside this two holder and the first module will come out here. Let's put it this way. So let's hold again for the second module. Alright, and let's go for it. Let's install the Corsair Vengeance 1 and 2. So now we have an SSD and 16 gigs of RAM on our MacBook Pros, and the final thing I want to do is to install the second hard drive. So now we have to remove the super drive, and we need the standard screwdriver and the Torx screwdriver. So let's start maybe with a plastic tool, or if you have nails, remove the connector of the super drive. Remove this second connector right here. So lift up this cable and just pull it out. Just pull out, don't pull up. Then remove the two screws, just one here and one here, to detach the structure here. So take out all the screws just to avoid the possibility to lose them. So now we have down here There is a Torx screw down here, there is another one, and down here there is the third one. So let's see if we can manage to remove the screws. The first one seems fine. Let's go for this one, that is the hardest one. Done. The last one here. I hope it's the last one, but this is the first time for me. And let's see. So lift it up and pull it out. Well, it was easier than I thought. So from the normal super drive, we need the connector right here. It's just easy to remove it. Just take it apart. And even this holder to hold in place the new adapter. One and two. I think it's going to be like that. So this is going to be here. So let's take it in his place here. Let's put everything back in place. Let's put everything back where it belongs. So let's start from this one here, just to hold one. Here, the main screw to hold down. So basically we are gonna miss two screws. We just have the top one, and the thing is locked because there is this plate here, this screw here, but it just moves around like this. We have to do something to solve the problem, to put here some kind of adhesive, like maybe this one. So he's not moving, and actually this adhesive was on the old hard drive, so the temperature is fine, he can reach that kind of temperature, and he's not moving, so everything is done, it seems. Let's hope for the best.